In this channel, I've done several makeovers of my art studio and art desk setup using furniture that I've either collected over the years, bought at Goodwill, and just kind of mishmashed together into a Frankenstein-y mac and cheese art studio. But after so many years of doing this, it was time for me to upgrade and get the art YouTube desk setup in the way that would serve and help me perform at my best. So this is my journey to figure out what I wanted for my ultimate dream art and YouTube desk setup.
I have blisters all over my hands.
So, let's get into it. I have two different criteria that I'm looking for. One, I want an area where I can put all my paint supplies and set up all my camera stuff so that I can film my art YouTube videos, primarily overhead shots. And let me tell you something, it is not the easiest thing to find without doing some like insane camera rigging. So I wanted something that was clean and give me enough space with minimal setup to do all the work that I wanted to do. Secondly, I needed somewhere where I can do my video editing, do my computer work, and all those other little tedious things that I would need doing video narrations and video editing, and the places to store all my other random junk that I need on a daily basis. So what I was thinking about doing for an art desk setup was an L shape. I can swirl my desk chair from doing art to editing without having to get up and do all the extra work of going from one place to another. I had a plan of how I wanted it to go. Now comes the execution. Looking at desks online that have an L-shaped look to them, it was extremely expensive and it didn't give me a lot of storage opportunities. So I had to kind of go the custom route for that. When I first started looking for all these items for my desk, this was pretty much towards the height of the pandemic. Half the stuff that I needed just were not available. So I had to come up with some creative substitutes in order to get the desk that I was looking for. Now, you'll see a lot of art YouTubers have a certain type of desk, the Alex drawers, as well as like that tabletop that goes along with them. Unfortunately, totally out of stock. So I ended up buying two 72-inch countertops for two reasons. One, the other tabletop wasn't available, but two, if I were to paint and spill a bunch of stuff all over the place, it allows for easy cleanup, minimal warpage, and it actually is made from a better material, and it's cheaper. As well as three Alex drawers to act as the legs of the table, and additional table legs for added support. After doing some assembly,
get in your hole.
I was able to come up with something that looked really, really decent.
Then once I got those drawers assembled, it was time to clear out my space.
I hope to God this is one of the last times I have to do this. Pray for me.
The way that I kind of put this together was kind of like this. One of my desks would have two Alex file cabinet legs, as well as a regular table leg at the back center of the desk for added stability. My other desk would have one Alex tower drawer and would have three additional table legs, two for the other side of the desk, as well as one for the back center support for added stability. And just to prevent things from sliding back and forth, I ended up putting some of those 3M Velcro strips underneath the countertop just to make sure that nothing would be slipping around when I was working. So once I had that arranged, I had the big question, where was I gonna put all my art supplies so that I could easily see them? In a previous video I did, Once Upon a Time, I did the KonMari method, which turned me onto the idea that I want to be able to see everything and not have to dig through all my art supplies to go find something. I'm a mom, I have no time for this bullshit. I need my thing and I need it now. First, I went with a shelf approach where I just took an old shelf, turned it sideways, threw all my art supplies at it, but it took up a lot of desk space that I was not really ready to give up. After some brainstorming, I decided to go with a pegboard system, and it just so happens that IKEA has some pretty great pegboard stuff. So I decided to purchase two pegboards from IKEA, as well as some of their accessories that go with the pegboard, like their shelves and their little cups, some little hanger thingies, and proceeded to install those onto my wall, which was also very, very simple to do. A little measuring, a little leveling, some drywall anchors, and we were all set to party. And then once I had my pegboards all installed, it was time to do some aesthetic art supply decorating. This is where I felt like I was shining. My organization boner was going through the roof, and I proceeded to put all my art supplies and organize them in a way where I can easily see them and pick them up while I'm at my desk shooting a video. If ever I wanted to switch things out, add more cups, add more shelving, I can totally do that because it's a pegboard. It's super easy to do. And I cleared out all of my desk space, so I have all this ample 72 inches of pure magic that I could be working on. Now I want to talk about my actual art desk setup and what it is that I do in order to film my art videos. So in the past, what I actually used to use was my iPhone for filming my art videos, as well as an overhead tripod stand that would hold onto my phone and use like a series of linkages to go over the areas that I wanted to film. The problem with my old camera setup, I kept running out of space every 30 minutes. I was in the middle of filming and getting into the groove with something. My videos would just stop filming. So I was dealing with space issues constantly. So I decided to invest in myself and actually buy a real camera with a real microphone and a real overhead tripod system. Using the Canon EOS 50, I thought was the best starter camera, and I just wanted something that can give me great autofocus and can give me that flip screen so I can get the best shots with great focus, great clarity. It was a no-brainer. It had to happen eventually. Then I also invested in a Rode mic, which I just plug straight into my Canon camera. Great sound quality. In fact, this is what I'm talking into right now. It just helps with the overall video quality. And I can use this mic for both my overhead shots as well as my direct shots. Now my overhead tripod isn't exactly an overhead tripod. I know, scandalous. It's actually a screen monitor holder, which I then just zhuzhed up into an overhead tripod. I actually learned this from another YouTube user who came up with this idea, and I was like, that's brilliant. So I decided to go ahead and copy that, and I'll include her video in the description as well. Bought an additional ball joint that I can attach to that stand and then attach a camera and then orient it any which way I want to do great overhead shots. And what's really nice too is that this is so sturdy, it can hold a lot of weight. So if you got a pretty heavy camera with all the camera equipment like a microphone attached to it, this thing is not gonna go anywhere. I also have a regular tripod that I got so many years ago, my first ever tripod for making my videos. And that's what I use for all of my direct talking shots, like the one I'm doing right now with you. While I'm filming and I want camera shots that come from the side, I actually have this Joby phone stand as well as this iPhone holder from Newer, which I just put together. I attach my phone to it and then I use this for my side shots from when I'm doing my art videos. On either side of my desk, I have two softbox lights that help to illuminate my art surface so that I can create videos that look pretty snazzy. Now let's talk about my YouTube editing desk. This desk features my desktop computer. I used to work with a laptop for many, many years. We're editing a lot of videos, and the desktop can handle all that extra memory and RAM to get faster editing, as well as a 12 terabyte hard drive, which was yet another investment that I made for my art, because we do a lot of videos, which takes up a lot of space, which then needs to be stored. And after going through about 4 Passport external hard drives, it was about high time to just get one big kahuna that would just plug straight into my computer and would act as the central storage location. And yeah, it's helped. It's helped a lot. It's fantastic. And then off to the side of my computer, I have my tripod with my Samsung USB microphone. This microphone is what I use when I'm doing my video narrations on my channel. I can easily just take it and do what I have to do and then quickly set it right back up again. And to the left of my computer is my printer scanner so that I can print important documents and scan my artwork and do all those fun things. The Alex drawers are the perfect place to store all of my post-it notes, canvas papers, and all the other extraneous art supplies that I don't really use very, very often. I didn't realize I needed all this storage, but it helps a great deal. So yeah, putting together this art and YouTube desk setup took some time. In fact, it took almost 10 months of putting this together, filming it, and editing in order to show you what I have here today. But I do want to emphasize something really, really important. This is something that I have been working towards for many, many years at this point. But when I first started, I did not have all the funds available to do this, so I just had to work with what I had. I used old furniture, I used old phones. It took a little while to get here, but after a lot of hard work, I was able to get the dream desk set up that I've always, always wanted. It's been nothing but fantastic. I absolutely, absolutely, absolutely love it. So guys, what do you think about my desk setup? Does it inspire you? Does it give you some ideas for your own desk setup? Comment below and let me know, my darling queen bee. And if you guys are more in the mood for some more DIY art studio makeovers and ideas and inspiration, be sure to click on this playlist right over here, and I'll see you there.